Shebevadai Seife Lasis Tshuva. There's no question, there's no doubt.
Why?
That you will do Tshuva. Begilgul Zei, Begilgul Acher. Whether it's in this Gilgul, whether in this lifetime or another lifetime. Why? Kila Yidach Mimenu Nidach. Because the Pasuk says in Shmuel that the Eibishter V'chishev Machshavis, the Eibishter, he made plans that Levilti Yidach Mimenu Nidach, that no Yid should remain, a Nidach should remain pushed away.
Should remain
Nidach pushed away, should remain
separated. Rejected.
Yeah, rejected.
Here's what it says, rejected.
What do you mean rejected?
Yeah.
By Hashem.
By the Eibishter. Everyone does tshuva then. Chassidim, they say that there was a chassid whose name was the Rashbatz. He was called the Reb Shmuel Bitzal. He was a teacher of the Friedrich Rebbe. He was a chassid of the Tzemach Tzedek still, and he later became a teacher of the Friedrich Rebbe. And they say that when he used to teach this Perek, when he reached these words, he would cry, and he would say, "Kinderlach, Kinderlach, children, children, we're gonna do tshuva. We may as well already do it now. Why are we pushing it off? It's going to happen. By hook or by crook, we will do tshuva, so why delay it?" There are some people who play the stock market and they gamble. Some people win. Some people play the stock market and they gamble and they lose. Can you imagine the Eibishter Hashem playing the stock market and losing? You are Hashem's stock market. Hashem gambled on you. And Hashem doesn't fail. Hashem doesn't lose. What I'm saying now is a very deep idea. If there is a Yid who doesn't do tshuva, that means that the Eibishter failed. The Eibishter invested in something, and the Eibishter wanted it to work, and it didn't work. It failed. And that's not something that we can accept. Every Yid has an neshama. And every single Yid is going to do tshuva. Because Hashem invested in every single Yid. And every single Yid got an neshama. And every single Yid has a mission. And the Eibishter gets his way eventually. We can't destroy the Eibishter's plans. What we could do is delay Hashem's plans. Because Hashem, you could decide to do it today. You could decide to do it tomorrow. But you do not have the option not to do it. Because Hashem's will happen. Kol asher chafetz Hashem asa, whatever Hashem desires is going to happen. And Hashem created you for a reason, for a purpose. As we discussed in earlier prakim, it's not that Hashem created and says, okay, you know what? I'll make how many millions of Yidden? I'll make 50 million Yidden, 60 million Yidden. And this way, if most of them do good, we're fine. Then my plan for the creation of the world happens. Remember, we learned earlier in Tanya, it doesn't work that way. Every single Yid has their own job. And you're going to have to do your job. And the whole world is waiting for you. The Mashiach is waiting for you to do your job. And you're going to do it, and you're going to do tshuva. Now, it's up to you to decide when. But tshuva, you will do.